All right, you guys, God bless you. Listen, I'm just going to get right into this right away. I'm sorry. We just got to get right into this. Guys, we're at the precipice. I think from what I'm seeing, some things that have happened in the last couple of days that I haven't shared with you yet. I'm trying to figure out how to share it with you. So I'll do that in this video. I'll show you what would be really good if you would take some preemptive steps before I share with you some scriptures that the Lord gave me that are they're world changers. Again, you know, when I tell you all that, when I say the Lord's given me a scripture that's a world changer, you know that Genesis 1, 26 and 27, when Elohim said, "Let us create man in our image," and the Lord told me, look up the word image, and it means a representative figure, especially an idol. That is a world changer because of all the things that come with that scripture that we've all been lied to about, and all the evidence. I mean, it's a yes or no. Is the Vatican a snake? Yes or no. Is there another building alongside it that's a snake? It's a yes or no answer. See, so the Lord will give me scriptural nuclear just warhead scriptures, then he will back them up with supernatural data like the Vatican's a snake. Audience Hall is the snake birthing out of it. He'll give me the ability to show you just, you know, when you invert everything, the Virgin becomes a dead sheep. Largest altar in the world is a dead sheep with its tongue sticking out. You know, all the data that comes with the scripture, that's called a confirming witness. Okay, so anyway, I'm going to give you guys a scripture to look at. I'm going to show you what might be really good for your mind so your brain builds a mental image of what we're going to be talking about. So I have a little link. You can go watch the movie Samson. It was pretty good. I watched it, and you know, of course, you know, it's a movie, but still, it was pretty good, and it gives your mind a way to kind of make images in your head along with the scriptures that we're going to be going over, because it is so profound. It is so perfect. Kind of like, remember Nahash, when Nahash the Ammonite said to the men of Jabes-Gilead, I'm sorry, I'll butcher that name, Jabes-Gilead. Anyway, I butchered it. Anyway, but Nahash the Ammonite, that means the serpent, she's a female, the serpent, the inbred race. That's literally what it means. Nahash the Ammonite said to the men of Jabes-Gilead. Anyway, you know, we'll thrust out your right eyes, and you will be a reproach to all of Israel. And that was the covenant they said, we're going to make with your race of beings. Just stop and think about that. And to be able to show y'all all that imagery that goes with it, I mean, that's just so mind-boggling. So I want you guys to watch this Samson video. I'll put it in the link, but I want to bring your attention to one of the very first things that the Lord had me do. Was show everybody the US currency, the bombings of the Twin Towers and the Pentagon are printed on the $20 bill made in 96. The federal building bombing from Oklahoma City is printed on the old $20 bill that I grew up with. And when you turn the bill over, there's the building blown in half. So that was what the Lord told me. I had to go to the FBI and show them where the bombings on the money and the other bombings that would be happening that are printed on the $50 bill, the $100 bill, the $10 bill, and out of the sea shall come fire and smoke and a devouring wind. Okay, that's a nuke, you guys. Then water as high as the walls of Jerusalem will cover the city by the sea. That's a tidal wave, you guys. Okay, well, those very words match the new images that came out on the $100 bill and the $10 bill. The $100 bill shows buildings being devoured by a nuclear wind. They're just disappearing. There's three layers of ink that reveal that. I'm going to play that short little video clip here in just a sec, but I want to talk about it first. Then water as high as the walls of Jerusalem, that's a tidal wave, will cover the city by the sea. that's printed on the $10 bill. So my goodness, it's like stupid obvious. Okay, I know it's coming because they printed it on the old money, and like the Twin Towers and the Pentagon. Did those bombings happen? It's a yes or no. Was anybody able to show you all that stuff? No, the Lord showed it to me back in 2002 is when I started coming out with this stuff. Okay, so now here we are in 2024, and we're at the door of nuclear war with Russia. Isn't that a perfect setup for the entity that's running the puppet show to get everybody to believe, oh, Russia did it? So World War III can happen, where everybody's just blinded by the nonsense media, the lies. The bombings of New York are printed on your new $100 bill and your new $10 bill. I went to the FBI and showed them. So I want to remind you of something that Biden said a while back, and listen to his words back then. And now we have Russian subs showing up in Cuba, you know, without getting into the Cuban Missile Crisis and all that, for all those of y'all that know about it, this is far worse. They talk about nuclear war now like it's just some part of the conversation. It's like growing up, my mom used to say, you know, if you're ever in a relationship and you're married, don't ever throw the word divorce out. She said, once it comes out of your mouth, once that, then that's what's coming out of that person's heart. Said, you don't ever just throw those kind of words around, because then it becomes a reality and it, you know, it manifests. So does the word nuclear war. I'm telling you guys, you don't throw those words around like that. And they're so glib, and you know, the whole O'Biden administration, they're all about it. Okay. Now, let me show you a couple clips real quick. Let's just do this. Let's just hang out for a minute. I feel a little bit stressed out. Sorry, guys, because I got a lot on my plate. I want to show you guys this folder right here. It's called Special Projects 2. The costume is the most important part to deceive. But right here, you see, right, this bottom link right here, it says Samson Movie. It would be really great if you wanted something to watch for about an hour to watch the Samson Movie right here in my show notes. And then I'm going to show you something down here in these show notes. There's a lot of scriptures that I've been putting in here that we're going to talk about. And we're going to be talking about Judges 14:14 and some of the super, super, super crazy things that have happened in a testimony, like kind of like if I laid hands on someone that was terminally ill and they got well like very quickly. The Lord's had me do those type things. And this is one of those things where it just happened out of left field. I wasn't ready for it. And then all of a sudden I was like, oh my gosh, this is something everybody needs to see. Okay. Let's jump into the US currency thing real quick. Let me show you this. So I'm going to open Special Projects 2. So the folder right here, if you want to, you see that right here? I'm highlighting it blue. See my address bar right here? I'm going to put that in the show note description. So watch. So whenever I do my next video, watch this, that the video that you're going to be watching, watch this. Here's the way it's going to work. You're going to click on my video. You'll click on the video, and then you'll, right here where it says, right underneath my moniker right here, you'll see, in this gray area, you'll see the links to this show notes server right here. And then you can go to Special Projects 2. And right here, I'll put the link for this one as well. I'll put that link also for you. And it'll be right here in the video that you're watching right here. You'll go right there. And that way you can watch Samson. And then you can also start reading the scripture that the Lord's given me. It is unbelievable what he's going to let me show you. So for any of y'all that want to watch the shorty, I'm going to pull this up. I'm going to pull this little short video clip up just to remind you. In 2007 is when I came forward into the general public and said, okay, the Lord has absolutely demanded that it was time for me to go in front of the public. And when I did, I gave you guys the prophetic utterance that the Lord had given me, and I showed you the hieroglyph of Akhenaten and Nefertiti broken down, and then the prophetic utterance he gave me, and I showed y'all the bombings on the U.S. currency. And that's what the Lord had me put together as my, like, coming out video. It's in a channel called Secret Mystery Busted, and it's called the Just a Messenger series. I'll leave that link in here too. You can go to KleckFiles.com and find the Just a Messenger series. Just go to KleckFiles.com and type in the address bar, Just a Messenger series. Okay. Let's watch a quick recap of what's on your money. What's on the money in your wallet? Ready? So this is something you need to see again. Remind yourself.
Reports have shown, hidden in the United States currency notes reveals something very insidious. These images are disturbing. Viewer discretion is advised. Reports show the bills produced and distributed for the United States have printed on them bombings that have happened in the past, and bombings that will happen in the future. The immediate threat coming is a nuclear attack on New York City. It has all been planned from the beginning, and there is no stopping what is to come. These are clips taken from a video called Destruction of America, produced by Jonathan Kleck, and have been deleted by YouTube to continue to conceal the truth. We are now looking at the 1998 US $20 bill, alongside the Twin Towers moments after the attack that took place in 2001. As you can see, the money printed years prior to the attack is identical to the attack on the Twin Towers. Now we will turn the bill over to see the Pentagon bombing.
Okay, now I want to pause it right here. So on the back side of the very same bill that had the Twin Towers is the Pentagon. Now, the Lord showed me that. That was the Lord revealing that to me. And I think it was 2002. And that's when I had already been awakened and I was saved in 2001. I think it, yeah, my brain's kind of short-circuiting on years now. Anyway, but then I came forward with the U.S. currency notes. The old $20 bill that you're probably going to see right here had the federal building bombing on it. And it was just absolutely unbelievable. Oh, and then after I prophesied in 2007, out of the sea shall come fire and smoke and the devouring wind, water as high as the walls of Jerusalem will cover the city by the sea. Well, the $10 bill came out and shows a tidal wave covering a seven-story building. But then in 2014, the new $100 bill came out. I think it was 2014. And on that new $100 bill, it shows buildings just being devoured by a nuclear blast because there's three layers of ink on those bills. And I had old software that would allow you to see the three different layers of ink. And it played like a little three frame movie. Anyway, so again, let's look at this one more time. But right here is the Pentagon on the backside. So imagine on the backside of that same bill, where the Twin Towers is.
On the Twin Towers.
So there's the Twin Towers. And on the backside of the same bill is the Pentagon. But when you pick the bill up, there's the sigil of Baphomet made by the connecting vertices.
Now we will turn.
See right there? You see the five-pointed upside-down stars? Those, now I'm going to quote Isaiah. Those who try and hide their plans from the Lord are doomed. They carry out their schemes in secret and think no one will see them or know what they're doing. They turn everything upside down. So that bill, when you fold it and you make that pentagram right side up, make a right side up star, which represents our race of beings. When you turn that upside down, it shows their plans. Isaiah 29:15-16. Woe unto them who seek deep to hide their plans or counsel from the Lord. And their plans are in the darkness. Upside down. And they say, who seeth us? Who knoweth us? Surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as the potter's clay. So when I turn it upside down, I'm showing I belong to the Lord God and I'm exposing their plans. That's what the U.S. currency was all about. That's why the Lord had me do it, to expose what their plans are. Satan's satanic plan is to nuke New York City and have everybody think it's Russia. That's what it is. It's already printed on your money. How could it be Russia? Remember when they closed the New York Harbor many years ago? They shut down all New York Harbor. They had, military boats out there and stuff. Everyone's like, what's going on? I wonder if they were planting something on the bottom of the ocean. Why is it printed on your money? Okay, the puppet show's over. I'm a harbinger. Okay, watch. If you don't believe I'm a harbinger, watch this. Is the Vatican a snake? Yes or no? Do people come up and draw pictures, say, Johnny, I drew a picture of you, and they put the same agenda as the Vatican? They put a serpent eating a sheep on the image they draw of me? I mean, come on, enough. It's stupid already. Okay, here we go.
Bill over to see the Pentagon bombing on the same bill, folded in the same pattern.
Look at that right there. I'm going to move this image of me. Watch this. I mean, look at this rectangular building. Look at my cursor. Look at the rectangular building right here. Look at the 1, 2, 3 rows of square windows. See it? See 1, 2, 3 rows of windows? And then here's the fire and smoke. I'm moving my cursor. And then there's the rectangular building. I mean, this is identical, you guys. Look at this.
This is now two attacks that happened on the same day, identically printed on the same United States $20 bill. If you're
and now we're superimposing right on top of the Pentagon. Look at that. It's identical.
This is real, or think it might be a coincidence. This is not the first time they printed an attack on your money. Let's quickly review the older $20 bill. This is the Alfred P. Murrah Federal Building bombing that took place in Oklahoma City in 19...
There's the three layers of ink. Look at that. I mean, come on.
1995.
There it is. Look at that layer of ink. I mean, look at what you're looking at. Do y'all have any idea what you're looking at? You're looking at a three-frame movie of the federal building bombing in Oklahoma City right there on your money. They took that bill out of circulation. I went and got a bunch of them so I could pass them around and show them to people. That's the old $20 bill. What's the Alfred P. Murrah building bombing doing on the $20 bill? Could somebody tell me that answer, please? Why is it printed on our money? Does somebody have an answer for that, please? No, because they're puppets that are being used by the one that runs the serpent race, which is Satan. Okay, why is the Twin Tower bombing on our new 20? Can someone tell me that answer, please? Why, when you turn that bill over, why is the Pentagon printed on that bill? Could someone answer that question, please? Why did the Lord have me prophesy out of the sea shall come fire and smoke and a devouring wind? Water as high as the walls of Jerusalem will cover the city by the sea. How did those words manifest onto the new $10 bill and the new $100 bill? So I just managed to spit out some words, and those words perfectly manifested on the new U.S. currency notes. That's quite a feat. Pretty impressive.
Some key characteristics worth pointing out is the...
So this is the Alfred P. Murrah building from the side view.
Rounded corners on the ends of the building, the face blown off, and the floors of the building jutting out. I will now take an image from the Oklahoma bombing and lay the $20 bill on top of it.
You can see the floors jutting out right here. Look
as
right
you can
here.
See,
Look.
We have another perfect match.
There it is.
Now we will go over the bombing that...
Now here's the $100 bill. Now... Pay attention. Now, look, if you go to collectfiles.com, you can go there and type in bombings on U.S. currency. And I have like 5 or 6 different very lengthy videos breaking this stuff down. I mean, it's a no-brainer. It's a done deal. So nuclear war is going to happen because there it is printed on our money. And I prophesied it years before they even made the images on the money. That's not possible unless it's going to happen. Okay, here we go. Watch the buildings. You'll see the three layers of ink. Watch, this is the new $100 bill.
That is to come. This is the United States $100 bill. Folded into the same upside down pentagram, you can see New York City being consumed by an explosion. There is hidden watermark ink on the bill that cannot be seen with the naked eye. Putting the image into computer software, I will show you each layer of ink that
shows... There it is. Okay, did you see it? Now watch. You'll see the three layers of ink. And, I mean, there's no arguing this. It's not arguable. Out of the sea shall come fire and smoke and a devouring wind. There it is right there on the $100 bill. Watch.
See the full destruction
boom,
of New
boom.
York City.
Okay, out of the sea shall come fire and smoke and a devouring wind. Watch.
With each layer of ink.
Okay, do you think that's possible?
Added, you can see the movement of the explosion coming towards you. We are front-loaded about this upcoming attack in many ways. Here is an example from a movie called The Day After Tomorrow. Putting the bill and movie clip next to each other, you can see they are front-loading the same agenda.
See, just pay attention, like right over here, you see the space, the light between the buildings right here? right here, the light between the buildings right here. And then they did the, you can see right here over where I'm moving my cursor, it looks like someone spilled some water on the ink right there. See that right there? That's what makes it change resolution. Like, that's what makes it change into that little three-panel movie, is those changes in ink when you change the magnification. It's got three different layers, three different changes. So boom, boom, boom. And it changes and it shows the buildings being devoured by wind. Who could even say those words out of the seashell confined smoke and a devouring wind? And that's exactly what the $100 bill is. Well, the reason I'm really like ringing the bell right now is because I want you to see what Joe Biden's been saying in the past. Because he said with his own mouth, if we were to give any kind of offensive weapons to them and any of this to Ukraine, well, that would be World War III. And the one thing that they said they weren't going to do, they're doing it. They're giving all kinds of offensive weapons into Russia. So anyway, see, Russia doesn't have to make a decision to go to nuclear war. So if you think that, you're misinformed. It is already printed on your money. It is already printed on your money. I'll say it one more time. Nuclear war is already printed on the $10 bill and the $100 bill. Showed it to the FBI in 2014 when that bill came out. The Lord told me, now go show this to the FBI. And I did. And I told you, one guy was just like, what the heck? And the other guy looked like he wanted to kill me. Okay, here we go. Ready? Here it is. Here's a side by side. Here's a day after tomorrow right here on the left. And you can see the space between the buildings and you'll see water rushing through here. Here is the same scenario. Here's the building right here. Here's the open space between the building. Here's the building over here. Let me move this picture. There you go. And then this is the water coming through and the building's being devoured. Watch. I mean, look what you're looking at.
Looking on the next image, hidden on the same $100 bill, you can see a nuclear missile impacting the water. The watermark layers of ink show the water splashing from the impact of the nuke. Laid on top of the bill is a missile strike and how it would look to show you the resemblance between the two. Finally, let's look at the new $10 bill and review the exact same agenda hidden on it. Firstly, notice the orange tint on the bill. This was done with intent. On the top of the image, you will see a large explosion happening while the building has a large tidal wave pouring over top of it. In the
You know what? I want to show y'all something. This is really important. Watch this. I'm going to show you something in Google Images. Watch this. $10 bill, $10 bill, front and back. Okay, there you go. $10 bill front and back. Here we go. Now, let me show you something first. Here's the $10 bill that was out before that came out. I want to show you why this one wouldn't work. You see, I'm gonna look at my cursor. You see this line right here? You see this like line that closes in the oval right here? See that line of ink? That won't allow a ti these trees to look like the tidal wave. I want you to look at these trees right here. You see these trees right here? Take a little look at them. Now, let me show you the new $10 bill. Watch what they did. Watch this. So look, they took off the line. See, the line is missing. So when you fold this thing, look at these trees. That's a wave. There's no line going around it anymore. You see how fuzzy it is at the top, like a wave in the ocean, how the top of it gets like that. If it had a double line here, it wouldn't look like that at all. I want you to look at the tree. Look at the direction of the tree's energy, like going this way. It's called movement. See, the movement is going this way. Look at all the movement. The tree movement is going this way, this way, this way, this way. And look over here. Look over here. The tree movement is going this way, this way, this way, this way. That's because when you fold it, and look how they made it orange. Well, are nuclear explosions Is there orange in there? So here you go. Now we'll click on this one. There it is. So now this is the one that they used to make the, so the new $10 bill came out after the Lord gave me that utterance, or the $10 bill came out, the new orange one came out, and then out of the sea shall come fire and smoke and a devouring wind. That's a nuke. That's on the $100 bill. Water as high as the walls of Jerusalem will cover the city by the sea. That's on the bill you're looking at right now. How's that even possible? So see, this war with Russia and them posturing themselves, it's a puppet show. It's gaslighting. It's a done deal. It's a foregone conclusion. It's on your money. So do you think it's not going to happen? Of course it is. Okay, now watch. Let's go back to this. Now here's a good image of it. Watch this. You can see the tidal wave coming over the seven-story building, and right here where my line is, you'll see this building's reflection in the water. You see this white line going across right here? You'll be able to see this building's reflection in the water. Okay, here we go. Let's do it again.
In the bottom portion of the image, you will see the building's reflection from the water flooding. The threats are real and should be taken seriously. For more information, links are in the description below.
Gave me the Vatican's a snake.
Yeah, the Vatican's a snake. See it? So the Lord doesn't miss. So he's the one that showed this to me. So I'm putting it all on him. He showed it to me. I'm showing it to you. Okay, now let's do the Biden thing. The O Biden. Here we go. Okay, listen to this.
As we provide this support to Ukraine, we're going to continue to stand together with our allies in Europe and send unmistakable message that we will defend every inch of NATO territory, every single inch, with a united, galvanized NATO. One movement. That's why I moved over 12,000 American forces along the borders with Russia, Latvia, Estonia, Lithuania, Romania, etc. Because they move once. Granted, if we respond, it is World War III, but we have a sacred obligation on NATO territory, a sacred obligation, because they move once. Granted, if we respond, it is World War III, but we have a sacred obligation on NATO territory, a sacred obligation, Article 5, and we will not, although we will not fight the Third World War in Ukraine. Putin's war against Ukraine was never be a victory. Democrats are rising to meet the moment, rallying the world on the side of peace and security. We're showing that.
Okay, I can't even listen to this loser anymore. I'm sorry. Guy's a sick man. It's printed on your money. They're posturing now. All the subs that are allegedly, coming towards the US with Russian nuclear armaments. That is a huge heads up. That's called gaslighting. They're gaslighting everybody right now. It's already printed on your money. Either you've seen it and you believe it, or you don't. Let me show you how to go to Kleck Files real quick. Ready? Watch this. You can do a Google search and do Kleckfiles.com right here. Okay, Kleckfiles.com. Okay, do that. When it comes up, let's see what happens. Watch, they'll shut this down. Okay, so here it is, kleckfiles.com, right here. Okay, so right here is a search button, right here. See it? Search. And all my, look at all the years are in here. Look, here's the Justin Messenger. See it right here? Here's Justin Messenger series. So you can click on this, and this is when I came out. This is the very beginning of me coming out. And that's, Justin Messenger right here, the intro, and then part one, part two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11 parts. So there's 11 parts to it. They're each about 10 minutes apart, but right here, you can go watch it all.
Is a blue shoots up through the stony ground. There's no room, no space. space to rent in this town. You're out of luck. And the reason that you had to care, the traffic is stuck.
Okay, so listen up, guys. So you guys can go there and you can watch anything you want to watch on Kleck Files. So go to Kleck Files, and right here you can look for let's do U.S. currency bombings. U.S. currency bombings. Let's see if some pops up. The time of her judgment. So this looks like an hour-long video on that stuff. So anyway, I think if you'll go do a little hunting on KleckFiles.com, there's at least 8 to 10 really good videos that are extremely broken down on the U.S. currency. But now they are talking way too much about it. So I'm warning you. All right. Now, here's the other thing. I want to give you guys incredible scripture revelations. To me, scripture revelation is bigger than anything. And what the Lord's got to show you guys is just mind-blowing. So if you'll go to your folder and you'll go to the This Is The End right here. This Is The End show note folder. Special Projects 2 with the bell right here. You'll click on that. And then you go right here to the costume is the most important part. And when you go here, you'll see a lot of scriptures. You'll see Zechariah right here. Really incredible scriptures here in Zechariah. And then when you get to Judges right here, you'll see Judges 14:14. And I'll just click right here on Judges. This is a world-changing scripture. And if you understand what happened with Samson, this is one of the most mind-boggling revelations that the Lord's given me in scripture since I've been working for the Lord. So anyway, I want to give you a really good presentation. I don't want to just rush into it right now. I want to put it together in a way that's very, very easily understandable with all the other data points. Because the Vatican's a snake, guys. Female energy is what is destroying the whole place. It's not if you're a woman or a man. The whole thing is a puppet show created by twin female energy. Some people say, are you saying women are bad? No, for the thousandth time. It's part of the system. You have male from heaven, female from the pit, energy. Hell hath enlarged herself beyond measure. Him, our Father, who art in heaven. Heaven is up, hell is down. Male energy's up, female energy's down. The host body system is just a shell. That's it, in which the energies react and they duke it out through angelic and demonic forces. And we have our soul that we are supposed to be protecting, but we're in really dangerous places these days. So the only thing you can do is to turn back to your Creator and ask Him to clean you, because no one is going to survive the future that's coming. When Noah warned everybody, he warned everybody like, hey, the end is coming. He started building an ark, and him and his family were saved. It's no different. Now, flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God. Flesh and blood cannot inherit it, the kingdom of heaven. So what does that mean if you're going to inherit the kingdom of heaven? You're going to leave your shell behind. And I am trying to get everybody ready so you're not afraid to leave your shell. Got it? You're going to have to be willing to stand there and say, I'm ready. Okay, so anyway. All right, guys, I'm sorry. I've got so much stress right now that I'm trying to carry and get this stuff out to you guys. So please bear with me. All right, here we go. Ready? Back to this guy. What did he say? He said it'd be World War III, right?
We're going to welcome Ukrainian refugees with open arms if, in fact, they come all the way here. And as we provide this support to Ukraine, we're going to continue to stand together with our allies in Europe and send an unmistakable message that we will defend every inch of NATO territory, every single inch, with a united, galvanized NATO. One movement. That's why I moved over 12,000 American forces along the borders with Russia, Latvia, Estonia, Lithuania, Romania, etc. Because they move once. Granted, if we respond, it is World War III, but we have a sacred obligation on NATO territory, a sacred obligation, Article 5. And we will not, although we will not, fight the Third World War in Ukraine.
Sorry, little glitch. Keep paying attention. Sorry about that.
Because they move once. Granted, if we respond, it is World War III, but we have a sacred obligation on NATO territory, a sacred obligation, Article 5. And we will not, although we will not, fight the Third World War in Ukraine. Putin's war against Ukraine was never be a victory. Democrats are rising to meet the moment, rallying the world on the side of peace and security. We're showing the strength and we'll never falter. But look, the idea that we're going to send in offensive equipment and have planes and tanks and trains going in with American pilots and American crews, just understand, and don't kid yourself, no matter what you all say, that's called World War III.
Okay, so what are we doing now? Well, we're doing exactly that. Sending in fighters, F-16, all these offensive weapons. Guys, it's printed on your money. Okay, so when I see them pushing the envelope to meet the gaslighting expectation of the minds of the population of the world, that's when I'm like, wait a minute. They're getting everybody ready now because it's already on your money. Is it? So here's the thing. Is the Vatican a snake? Yes or no? Yes or no? Is a Twin Tower bombing printed on your $20 bill? Yes or no? Is the Pentagon printed on your $20 bill? Yes or no? Is a federal building bombing printed on it? Yes or no? Do you believe that the new bombings that the words that came out of my mouth, out of the sea shall come fire and smoke, and a devouring wind, water as high as the walls of Jerusalem, will cover the city by the sea. Those very words ended up being printed as images on new bills? Yes or no? I've already shown you the bills. So do you believe that's what's going to happen? Okay, I'll just leave it at that. Okay, I love you in Christ. It looks like we are maybe facing those final moments, guys. Anyway, no one knows the hour of the day. Nobody does, but I'll tell you what. With what the Lord showed me scripture-wise the other day, that I'm telling you, I got to get out to you guys. Yeah, I would highly suggest that he's let me solve the riddle of the human race and prepare our hearts for time to go. Okay. All right, guys.
Obviously. Okay. Anyway, enough. Okay, the bombings are on your money. You're going to look at the folder and look at the scriptures. And if you can, watch the thing on Samson. Really a good short little film. I'm going to try and organize this folder for you guys. Sorry, I'm a little choppy tonight. Again, I've got a ton on my mind. I have a ton of supernatural scripture, supernatural testimony. And I see everything coming together like it's all about to go. So anyway, I love you in Christ. I'll be here for sure in the next day or two trying to get that other scripture video out to you guys. And we're working on other videos as well right now. All right. God bless you guys. All right. I don't want to be so stressed out. I forget to give everybody a hug. Okay. I apologize, guys. I'm just like, it's like... There's so much going on in the world right now, you guys. We're obviously at the end. Anyway, that's you. This is Johnny. I love you in Christ. Peace and grace. And I will get this stuff to you as quickly as I can. I've had a very just challenging week. Okay.